All right, welcome back. You're still watching Closing Trades right here on ET Now. I'm Amrish Baliga, Managing Partner, Global Wealth Management at Edelweiss Financial Services, joins us on the show right now. Amrish, good to have you on the show. What's a call that you're making on the market? Do you think that this rebound is sustainable, or are we going down again?
In fact, for a while, we've been asking our clients to get into cash to a large extent, because whatever sort of a bounce back you see would be quite temporary. We have seen some bounce back just lasting for a day. Now we have seen this bounce back lasting for the last two and a half days. So I really don't see it really lasting much beyond possibly tomorrow, day after sort of things. So I would suggest that even at these levels, one should be exiting to a large extent, because clearly I don't see the markets crossing that 5,500 levels.
Do you think that, you know, and since you talk to a lot of institutional investors, do you think that there is perception building of a potential derating for India, if that has already not happened? Derating of the market?
No, I mean, that possibility is there of derating. Yeah, I mean, re-rating of India, in fact, derating of India, I think that is also a possibility going ahead. And clearly, we, I mean, with the way the rupee is going, we don't know whether you finally look at rupee at 68 or 70, because this could be a temporary respite right now after this sort of, the sort of a depreciation which you have seen in the last last 4 or 5 weeks. It's possible that we could hold on at these levels and then again possibly depreciate to those levels of 68. So, people are clearly taking an extremely cautious view. So at this point of time, especially when people have lost money across various asset classes, just not equity, people have lost in debt too. So people prefer to, in fact, hold on to liquidity at this point of time, maybe look for the next 2 or 3 months as to where we go overall. And post that, I think they would take a view.
Seeing an interesting trend in IT in today's session. Yes, HCL Tech is up. Yes, TCS is up. Tech Mahindra is up 7.5%. So all of these stocks have done very well. CNX IT is up as well. Look at what's happened to Wipro. Should pull up Wipro individually for you. I mean, I'm just talking about the more liquid ones wherein traders are more active in. This one hasn't done anything. 447. It is seeing some build up on the FNO side for sure. But somehow the price movement is just not there in a Wipro. Everything else has done that. Wipro hasn't. So just watch out for this one. Amrish, this rally that we're seeing, before we get to metals, since you're on the topic of IT, this rally that we're seeing in the IT names in the last couple of days, valuations are not exactly peak, but they're not exactly cheap either. What is the advice on IT to your clients?
Valuations look stretched, but clearly, the way the rupee is moving, like I said earlier, in case we see a further depreciation in rupee, clearly, I think people would be investing more into IT, at least in the shorter term. So I don't see, immediate sort of a correction in IT. I think it can hold on for a while. And I think that's the only space to really hide for the time being. That's IT and pharma are the two spaces to hide. So I think one can just hold on for a while in this space, whereas the other space, which was called defensive, like FMCG, I think that's one space to be booked out to a certain extent.
And, you know, the other bit would be, what's the advice on metals to your clients, Amrish? I mean, yes, there has been some good news on the China front, but nothing on the domestic front as yet announced. Is it more an expectation of maybe the iron ore export news or something else coming out as well? Or is it, and is this more structural in nature, the bounce back that we're seeing in metals?
In fact, it seems that the cycle could start looking up, basically because there is good news from China. And at the same time, with Europe slowly coming back on track, I think that should be positive for some of our majors. For example, Tata Steel and Hindalco, I think, for both of them, that should be quite positive. But looking at the sort of a run-up which we have seen in the past few days, I think one should wait for a while before buying into metals. But yes, I think that's one space to get into at lower levels.
Ashwini, coming on Wipro, I mean, we're talking about CNX IT doing well. Some of the names have done extremely well. This one just hasn't, because I pointed out those 3 or 4 or 5 which have done well. Wipro continues to not move at all. What does one do here, if at all?
See, first of all, if something is not doing well, don't look at it. Secondly, the problem here is that it is not at new highs. Most of the other stocks are at fresh highs, and they are finding it much more easier to move up than Wipro. Wipro is also fairly close to new highs, but not really there. It is basically in a broad range of 320 to about, you could say, 480, 500. So it's still to make those fresh highs, and you know, each time it gets to the higher level of the range, and it's been a fairly long range, 3 year range. So people start selling off, but chances are Wipro should also at some point break out above 500.
Let's see if that happens. It's been a bit of a laggard compared to some of the others. Mitesh, it was a great call given on BHEL, and it certainly moved from the current market price 116, 117 odd. Are there more upsides? Because I think it's met your initial targets.
Yeah, I think the first target was around 115, 116. I think the second is at about 120, 123, and I do believe that the stock will head towards those levels. So I would suggest holding on. The only thing one somebody can do is to revise the stop loss just below about 112 and hold on for about 122 to about 123 on the upside.
By the way, just watch out for Sintex, since we're on the topic of cap goods. I think the futures trade on Sintex would expire this, I mean, would end at this expiry. And typically, we've seen with some of those stocks, if there are a bit of a trend on the downside or the upside, closer to the time when the futures trade will end completely, that some of the trade would have to reverse. So just watch out for Sintex if you are trading. This may not trade the same way as some of the other cap goods stocks will do over the course of the next 3, 4 days. Amrish, just come in. You know, this fascination with import substitution the last couple of days, 2, 3 days, and BHEL certainly seems to be riding it.
Yeah, that's true. But then again, looking at the way the economy is going out here, and clearly BHEL depends on the Indian economy, and we clearly don't expect that to recover quite fast. So, look, I mean, from that point of view, I don't think BHEL can really have a long-term move immediately. I think this is just a small knee-jerk reaction when people are talking of import substitution. Because of that, we have seen this move. I don't think it'll last too long.
I mean, you know, that's the argument, right? I mean, if indeed power plants are not getting the permissions, where does BHEL get its order book from? And last quarter numbers were anything but to write home about. So, yeah, a bounce may be a dead cat one. Can it last longer? Sure can. What to do with it remains to be seen. But 116 and counting for now, the trades on the long side are working for BHEL. Tell you what, let's get in those trading ideas at 255 as well. BHEL remains the top draw on the cap goods space. In fact, I was looking at the top gainers in the future space. This one also features top out there. Tech Mahindra follows closely. And stocks like Yes Bank haven't done too badly as well. So selectively, some of the banks are seeing some short covering too. Yes Bank out there. Non-banking, there is AB Nuvo, which is seeing a bit of short covering and going up in trade. So that one too has perked up in today's session as well. 1095 and counting for AB Nuvo. But 255, Mitesh, what is it that you're recommending at this hour?
Yeah, it's been on the recommendation list. JSW Steel, it's completed a pullback to its intraday averages today, should do well because the daily setup is also improving. So I would suggest buying this now with a stop at about 528 for targets of around 570.
Okay, while we are taking those ideas, just a quick word on the rupee as well. Pull up the intraday of the currency for you, 64.30. So it's kind of recouped all of the losses that it had midway through trade. Very close to the, actually, yeah, probably at the day's high. Yes, 64.30. So the rupee is at the day's high. It started off 64.33, if I'm not wrong, then went up all the way to 64.70. Now coming back slightly for the currency. So a bit of a pullback seen out there. Very volatile. No guesses what it will do. It probably again go back to 64.5 for all you know. But for now, yes, the rupee is also at the day's high. Maybe that is also aiding the sentiment. Tamrish, rather Ashwini, what is it that you would be recommending at 255?
Well, if rupee is going up, your tech stocks may not keep on flying the way they are. Although charts are looking positive, but people should reckon that if it closes, say, around 64 today, then tomorrow morning techs may open down. So it's a good idea to take it off on the techs. They've had a decent rally today. On individual stocks, you can look at Aditya Birla Novo. It's corrected back to its 200 DMA and then come back. So this is a buy with a stop around 1070. Look for 1150 on the upside.
Okay, let's take a break on that note then. 1.5% higher for the Nifty. So we have the day's high for the market as well, day's high for the currency as well. Despite the currency doing what it is doing, certain IT stocks are at the day's high as well. So, yep, green all around, except for maybe DLF and a few other names like Gitanjali, which continue to grind lower. But DLF is probably the only sore spot. Yeah, maybe add an Idea Cellular out there and the cement names. But otherwise, it's not been a bad day of trade. We'll take a break as we head into one, though. However, here out Hiren Ved, Director and CIO at Alchemy Capital Management, who says a selective approach should be maintained while picking stocks from the banking space. He expects rising yields and NPA woes to continue for the sector.
Most people were overweight in the banking space. And I think that with the kind of economic slowdown that we are seeing, NPA's worries, as well as the fact that yields have spiked, could put banks under pressure for a while. The weightage of banks in the index, which had become very significant, that could shrink a little bit. We like is some NBFCs and some of the deep value private banks. IT, I think, should continue to benefit because of the currency. I don't think that most models and earnings expectations are still carrying $57-58 to the rupee in their earnings. So we could see some upgrades going forward on the tech side. Maruti also looks very interesting. I think that if you're talking about a cyclical recovery post interest rate softening, there could be an opportunity there. And it could also include Bajaj Auto, because that's where the exports leg is very, very powerful. And again, because of good monsoons, you could see a revival in two-wheelers as well.
Oh, welcome back. You're still watching Closing Trades right here on ET. Now, Sandeep Bagla joins in with his recommendations in the market as well. Sandeep, what is it that you have for our viewers?
Tanvira, buy in HCL Tech, stop loss 915, target 980. A buy in BHL, stop loss 112, target 123. And a sell in DLF, stop loss 140, target 127.
Okay, that's a quick sell call coming in on DLF. Meanwhile, getting in an exclusive story. It's a crucial evening for the big power players in India. The ministerial panel will finalize the UMPP billing norms today, and will also decide on gas allocation for the sector. Nithya Balakrishnan met the power minister and is joining us with exclusive details. Nithya, what is Mr. Sindhia focusing on, and what is he saying on this matter as of now?
That's right. Power Minister Jyotiraditya Scindia believes that this evening could see a lot of traction as far as his sector is concerned. Empowered group of ministers will be meeting later today to take crucial calls on two issues. One, of course, diversion of gas to the power sector. The oil ministry has indicated to the power minister availability of 11 MMSCMD under new gas fines, and that they are working on a methodology to allow the power sector to reap benefits of this. Now, Mr. Scindia on record has indicated over 8,000 megawatt of power capacity is awaiting gas supply this very moment. So he is hopeful of some positive development on that front. Also, what he highlighted was the finalizing of the bidding documents for the forthcoming Ultra Mega Power project, something that the entire sector is keenly awaiting, is also expected later this evening. He seems to indicate that despite stakeholder concerns, asset and land ownership as well as fuel risk has been completely mitigated when it comes to the developer under the new bidding documents. And he believes that investor sentiment will be absolutely robust and intact once these bidding norms are finalized. So more details, of course, when that decision takes place later this evening. But another development that Mr. Scindia did highlight in our conversation earlier today was the fact that import duty on LNG, as far as the power sector consumption goes, for electricity generation, the government has agreed to bring it down from 5% to 0%. So a lot of development and more expected later that evening, as the power minister indicated earlier today.
Okay, Nithya, many thanks for that. Selectively, there's a spate of good news, Amrish, that is coming into the power space. If it was the tariff revision, MERC doing that as well for Adani Power, and now maybe some changing in norms for the UMPPs. Do you look at this space at all, or is it still just so troubled and so uncertain they just leave it out completely?
I think there's still a lot of uncertainty, and even when we're talking of gas fine, by the time the gas fine really reaches the power space, I think it will be, at least the next 12 to 18 months, if not more, And with just a few months left for the elections, I really don't think that this government can really take some clear-cut decisions as far as this space is concerned. So, I mean, I would be quite skeptical at this point of time as far as the, government decisions are concerned. So, I really will not pay too much of heed to that.
Amrish, what do you do with JP Associates? There's a lot of talk of the deal happening sooner rather than later, but cement is in a bit of a spot right now. What do you do with the cement names in general and JP in particular?
Every time there is a talk of this deal, this stock shoots up, 15-20%, and that's what again I expect, that when we talk of this deal, again it will move up some more from here. But earlier it used to move up from those 80 levels to whatever 100-110 levels, and now it's actually moving from this 30 levels plus. So I think only the figures have changed, that's all.
What about cement, Amrish? It is, of course, with the currency doing what it is doing, so many companies having imported coal as a large part of their overall coal portfolio, and those costs would be rising as well.
Right.
Is it, and this sector is not cheap, but what do you do with these companies? Say ACC Ambuja, if not JP.
Cement, again, not been too positive on this space. And now with the way the rupee is moving, that's also going to be hurting them as far as the margins are concerned. And again, since the economy also is not doing too well, I really don't expect that offtake to really move up, looking at the next couple of quarters. So I think even at these levels, most of the cement stocks are still looking a bit expensive.
Fini, maybe you gave a trade, but just wondering, on the large cap names, Ultratech, ACC, Ambuja, is there a trade, Ashwini, still there? Would you go ahead and short them if indeed the market is also showing a bit of an uptick?
Well, there seems to be some sectoral play here, but Ultratech is already down $400 from the highs, and if the market is, trying to go up, you would much rather go up with trade stuff that is going up than going down. For the moment, Ultratech, it broke down below 1700, so chances are that it should reach levels closer to 1450. 1500. Ambuja Cement, again, it's reaching targets of 145, 150. So I don't think there is much to go on the downside. Basically, we need the market to reverse to get into short trades again.
Ambrish, how would you position yourself in pharma right now?
Pharma, like I said, mostly I think one can hold on if you're talking of stocks like Sun Pharma or Lupin or possibly Dr. Reddy's to a certain extent, despite the fact that the last quarter was more of a disappointment. But other than these three or four stocks, possibly one should book out to a certain extent, because across, if you're looking at the valuations, they seem quite stretched. And especially when we are looking at the markets coming down going ahead, I don't think pharma can actually hold on at these levels. Surely they will fall, but may not fall as much as the markets would. But it's always prudent to get into cash as much as possible.
Okay, Amrish, so before we let you go, anything that you're advocating to your clients may be undervalued and therefore deserves a mention?
In fact, there are a number of stocks which are undervalued, but the question is, although they may look cheap now, they could get cheaper over the next 2 or 3 months. So, in fact, because of which we are saying, just hold on to cash. Surely the next 3 months will give you a lot of opportunities. In fact, we do see some more panic coming in, over the next 2 or 3 months. Possibly that could be the time, in fact, to enter the markets and put in your liquidity, because the same stocks which you are finding it cheap now could be cheaper going ahead.
Fair call, Amrish. We'll leave it at that. Thanks so much for taking the time out and being with us and giving us your views. Always good having you. Thanks for taking the time out. That's Amrish Baliga, Managing Partner of the Global Wealth Management Business of Edelweiss. Just a couple of other stocks, Mitesh, that I...